invite you to rise and celebrate. I will be leading intercession before the service can start. For me, what has been laid in my heart is that we may pray. We're going to pray together. Pray right there where you are. You pray in the spirit. Pray in your mind. Pray in any manner that you feel this is God. This is how God is going to hear you. So this is how I'm going to channel the prayer today. Obuti, let us pray for God to really reign, continue to reign and rule in our hearts. We've learned about personal altars, that I have a personal altar as an individual. So therefore, as an individual, now allow corner, nami lang corner, let every word that will be ministered be able to sustain me as a personal being in my personal altar, to say, Nkosi maqalekini imvuselelo, because I know when I'm strengthened, I'll be able to call other lepers in the season and say, let us march on. You know, why sit here and die? We will be able to rise together. So I'm inviting all of us to come and pray and say, Father, qinisa mina in the space, qinisa mina in the season whereby we will be depending on online preachings, we'll be depending on digital spaces to be able to release the word from different servants, from different platforms. But we say, Father, let every word that will be released, may it touch me. May I be the man that you want me to become. May I be the woman that you want me. May I be the child that you want me to become, that I may be able to rise and bring life to others, transmit life to others. May I be able to acquire the things that the Lord is releasing. Moko sata ya bashian de bosia lebra di zika ya bashian da ya bazeke de besianda koshata ya manda ya bazeke lebro no goshta ya bazeke de besia. Murimu, we just want to thank you. We just want to appreciate you for being God of our lives, my Father and my King. We salute you, we magnify you, we glorify you. We say you alone are God, you alone are mighty, you alone are gracious. Murimu, may your name be exalted. May your name be glorified, my Father and my King. Even in the space, oh God, the online space, oh God, we say that the Mujima Makaote, touch every individual, oh God. Touch your children, oh God, in their own personal altars, oh God. Let them be strengthened, oh God, as the word will be released, oh God. We are praying for understanding. We are praying for wisdom. We are praying for counsel. We are praying that the Mujima Makaote, that every word may strengthen us, oh God. We are praying that we may be able, Father God, to have minds that are alert and hearts that are receptive. Mudimuaka, it's amosebetuwa hawa harihadi pelotsa ronanta te mudimama kaweke. Let nothing be a boundary line, my Father and my King. We even continue with the spirit of intercession. We believe that as individuals, God is at work. God is at work. We are ready to receive, because God said, "Let us make men in our own likeness, in our own image and likeness." And he said, let them, you know, he said, let us. But then when he gave dominion, he said, let them have dominion. So be a rest assured that whenever you pray, there's something that takes place. Whenever we pray, there's something that is happening in the atmosphere, because of the dominion that has been given to us, because of the authority that has been given to us. Jesus Christ, and the power will come. You will be filled with power from high. You know, so sesiqwaliswe ngamandla. Whatever we are establishing, rana emhlabeni, it is happening. Whatever we are declaring, we know that uNkulunkulu is honoring it. Hallelujah, hallelujah. As we close our intercession, I just want us to move on and say and realize that again, bazalwane, remember, there are monitoring spirits in the season. There are monitoring eyes in the season that says that we want to monitor this church even online, but we say, lalela. The lesser power has to bow. We are here, we are taking charge. Therefore, we are praying for every preacher who is accessing this platform to be able to access now what? The families, because we are now seated at our homes as families. Remember, I said I've learned about the altars, your personal altar, we prayed about them. I'm just going to come. combine the rest of the altars as I have learned them. That now we prayed for your personal altar, that whenever you receive the word, it shall get to you, it shall influence you, and then you shall flourish in it. Now we're going to pray for the families that wherever they are, in all our spaces, wherever we are, we know that God is for us. The families are together, united in peace. We don't want irritations, we don't want bad news, we don't want anything. It is the time for the Lord now. Everyone will be settled. There won't be itchiness of doing other things other than being connected to what the servant of God will be saying, or rather what God will be saying through his servant. We're going to pray for the family altars to be strengthened and to stand strong. We're going to pray for the church. As a church, we are a body of Christ. As a church, see, we must unite. There must be one message. There was the Spirit of the Lord. Hallelujah. Now we're going to pray for the nation as well. We're just going to combine all those altars together. We started an individual altar. Now we pray also for the nation. Our nation, we also pray for the world as well. Hallelujah. That our leaders may be able to make the correct decisions. May they be able to discern. May they be sober-minded. We come against stresses and depressions as they make decisions as well. We pray that everything can go well with them. Even as this platform of preaching on digital spaces, may they also connect nationally. May we become one. Because even in the book, we learn about when the God's people were building the Tower of Babel. They were speaking one language, and God said, yeah. When people are in one accord, they can do wonders. They can even reach heaven, and God confused their language. That's when nationality started. But this is to say, when we are in one accord globally, we know that God will rise on our behalf. We know that there will be an impact. It doesn't matter what, but we know that gukona la siyakona mandaya bosha lebradi zika yamandorobo shika labrada zikeyebe shika. Mando yobo ze kalabradi zika ya mando robo shi kalabrada zekedebe sianda labrodoshia. Murimu, we are praying right now, Heavenly Father, for our families. We come against distractions during this time of prayer. We come against distractions during this time of celebration. We come against bad news. We come against irritations. Oh God, we shall be one as families. Let the word impact each and every child, each and every parent, each and every uncle, everyone, grannies, everyone. Let them be impacted as families. Oh God, and may they move in one heart and in one spirit. Let the message of the cross reach their hearts, oh God, in the name of Jesus. We declare unity, we declare oneness, we declare your mercy and your grace, my Father and my King. Not only that, in that we accelerate to pray for the body of Christ. We say that even in those platforms, my Father and my King, may we unite, may we become one in prayer. May we understand that the one who has called us, oh God, has called us to be one. Let there be one message, oh God. We come against distractions, oh God. The church will preach one message, oh God, because it is all about Christ. Let us be pointed to Christ. Let us fix our eyes unto Christ, oh God. As the body of Christ, oh God, it is no longer about who is doing what and who is not doing what.